In this video, we're going to work through an example in which we are going to calculate the air pressure at 40,000 feet above sea level using three different assumptions. One, that the fluid is incompressible. Two, that the fluid is compressible and isothermal. And three, the more realistic case in which we have a compressible gas, air, and a non-isothermal gradient. And a temperature gradient for our elevation, so a non-isothermal case. So the derivations for the equations we're going to use have been done in a previous screencast. We are just going to work through this example to show you the differences in values that we're going to get using these three assumptions. So in the incompressible case, we're saying that our air is an incompressible fluid, and that we are looking for some pressure, we'll say P1, it's related to a pressure at another height. So here we have our height of our air. So we're using the specific weight of air in this case. So that's something you would look up. And our value is 12.014 newtons per meter cubed if working in the SI system. So we need to convert our elevation of 40,000 feet to meters. And when we do this, we get about 12,190 meters. We also need to know one of the pressures to solve this. We know that our atmospheric pressure at sea level is 101.33 kilopascals. So our relationship for the incompressible case is that P1 is going to equal P2, the pressure at the ground, minus the height and specific weight of our fluid above it. So we can plug in some numbers and make sure that our units are the same. So here on the right side, we have Newton per meter squared, which is the same as a Pascal. On the left side, we have kilopascals. So we're going to have to divide these by 1,000 Pascals to make sure that our units are the same in terms of kilopascals. And we get a pressure of -45.13 kilopascals, which is an unrealistic answer. So, in this case, assuming that the gas is incompressible is a bad assumption. So, let's take a look at the case where we assume that the gas is compressible, but also that there's no change in temperature from sea level to our height of 40,000 feet. So, in this case, we're keeping the variables the same. The only real difference is the equation we're using. So our relationship for pressure and height for a compressible gas is going to be P1 is equal to P2 times exponential negative g for the gravitational constant, RT0, R is the gas constant, times our difference in elevation. Here we're using 9.807 meters per second squared as our gravitational constant. Also the gas constant, I'm using 286.9 joules per kilogram Kelvin, and looking up the temperature at sea level, found 288.15 Kelvin. You will find that everything inside the exponential ends up being unitless and canceling the units out. So we get a pressure P1 that is equal to 23.9 kilopascals. A much more realistic pressure, and one that's lower than that at sea level, and something that we would expect. So now the real question is, how much does it differ if we take into consideration that there may be a temperature gradient from sea level to the height of interest, 40,000 feet? For our non-isothermal case, we have a relationship between the pressure at P1 and P2. Using the following relationship, again derived in another video, where here T0 is our temperature at the sea level. Again, we're using G, our gravitational constant, R, our gas constant. And we have this new term beta, which is known as the lapse rate. Beta is basically the rate of change in temperature with elevation. So that's something you'd have to look up for our system. And for our first layer here, the first 40,000 feet above sea level, we found that beta can be written as 0.00650 Kelvin per meter. So obviously a very small change in temperature each meter of elevation, but this can be pretty significant when looking at a large change in elevation. So again, I'll plug in some numbers for our equation. And when I solve this, I get our pressure at 40,000 feet, or 12,190 meters, as 18.67 kilopascals. So now you can compare our two cases, the non-isothermal and isothermal case, and see there is a pretty significant difference, almost 20% difference between the two. So which one is more accurate in this case? So if we look at a table of the altitude versus the absolute atmospheric pressure, you will see that that reported, at least here on engineeringtoolbox.com, for 40,000 feet is 18.7, which is basically what we calculated for our non-isothermal case. So hopefully this gives you an idea of the vast differences that could occur and how important it is to make the appropriate assumptions when calculating your static fluid pressure.